Today's question, will the Hyperloop be underground? This morning, Elon Musk tweeted that he received verbal government approval for an underground Hyperloop between New York City and Washington, D.C. The route would also stop in the city centers of Baltimore and Philadelphia, picking up a total metropolitan population of about 35 million people. That's over 10% of the U.S. population. So what's so groundbreaking about this news? It means that Elon Musk is putting his money where his mouth is. Critics tend to call out Musk for not pursuing the Hyperloop himself, but it looks like he's joining the efforts now. So I know what you're gonna say next. Isn't it more expensive to build the Hyperloop underground? It may be more expensive now, but Musk has plans to drastically reduce the cost. First, he wants to decrease the tunnel boring diameter. This is important because boring cost increases roughly with the square of diameter, so cutting the diameter in half reduces cost by a factor of 4. Second, he wants to continuously add reinforcement to the tunnel while it's being dug. This means the tunnel boring machines would see less downtime, making them more cost effective. Third, he wants to ramp up power to the tunnel boring machines in order to dig faster. He claims he can triple the output of these machines by increasing power while using improved cooling systems. So, what are some of the benefits of an underground system? First, you can build it perfectly straight. At speeds above 500 miles per hour, minimum turning radius becomes extremely high, making it difficult to avoid obstacles like hills and buildings. By building perfectly straight tubes underground, this problem is eliminated. Second, underground tubes would be safer. The earth would provide a thick layer of protection against any outside threats. Third, it would eliminate the need for pylons. The original design called for pylons up to 100 feet tall, which was estimated to cost almost half of the total system cost. Clearly, the long-term future of tube travel lies below ground, but it may be more practical to build the early systems above ground. It's hard to say for sure until we see what kind of progress the Boring Company makes. As always, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time on Tube Travel.